we're just about there. Actually, we are there. It's 1 o'clock. Okay. Good afternoon, everybody, or good evening, or I don't think it's good morning, anyone. Maybe it is. Yes, and we are early today. We are early today because it's the 4th of July, and here in the United States, it's a national holiday, celebration of our independence. And as most people, or many people, do today, I've got a nice family gathering to go to later on this afternoon. It's 1 o'clock where I am in Eastern time. Again, I'm in the United States in just outside of Philadelphia. Always like to hear where all of you are watching from. So please let me know where you're watching from. We're going to go to our comments here in just a second. Yeah, actually, we're good. We can do some comments pretty soon. Yes, it's the 4th of July. And so we're doing an early show. I felt bad that I had to miss my show last week. I honestly can't remember why I had to miss last week. Oh, it's just been very busy with, as those of you who follow my live streams. By the way, let me know, again, let me know how the sound is, because I usually like to do my sound check before, but I didn't get to do it. So hopefully I'm loud enough and the background music is loud enough. As some of you who, all of you who follow my live streams may know, I'm in the process of selling my house and trying to buy a new house. And it's just a little bit crazy here in the United States. The real estate market is just kind of crazy. Like it's what they call a seller's market, because there's not a lot of houses available and there's a lot of people looking to purchase. So It's been exciting. It's been a little stressful, but it's overall been very exciting. So why don't we start saying hello to some people? And as always, hopefully you have your instruments ready to go. If you want to play along, if you have any requests of things you'd like me to play, I've got some music on my website we could look at. Oh, and I've got something very exciting here. I now have a piano camera. I promised you guys in a past live stream that when I have to show you piano stuff, now I have my very fancy piano camera. Look at this. So if you guys have any piano stuff I need to show you, it's right there. Isn't that fancy? Okay, let's say hello to some people. We're going to say hello to Samantha. Thank you for being here. And Shrek is a legend. Shrek is offering to answer any questions because he knows a lot about music. Okay, and Ice Legend has a question. We will answer as many questions as we can and request. Let's jump right into a question, actually. So Ice Legend, when I press the third pearl key on my saxophone, it closes. Oops, I got to move this over so you guys can see it. There we go. Okay. When I press the third pearl key on my saxophone, it closes the octave hole on the top and opens one on the side. Is that normal? Okay. Let's see. The third pearl key. Oh, I know what you mean. Yes, that is, you know, that's a great question. So everybody, you know, people that, let me start that sentence over again. Most people who are learning to play saxophone at some point discover that, you know, we all know that this is the octave key, right? But then you might notice that when you play some notes with the thumb is the octave key, and we all think that, you know, this is the one that goes up and down. And it is, except on some notes, it's not. So in other words, if you play a D octave key, 1-2-3, 1-2-3 octave key, look, the top, this thing does not move. Matter of fact, when you play a D, D, E, F, G, all of those notes, it's not this octave key that opens. It's this octave key right kind of hidden in here. There's actually two octave key openings. And the saxophone has a mechanism that works in a certain way. You know, for some reason, with the physics of the acoustics of the instrument, octave key works best here for notes below A. But then you'll notice when you go up to a high A, Look what happens when I go from G to A. Look right here. G, A, G. Can you see that? I'm going to go up real close. Super focus here. G, A, G, A, G, A, G, A. See it moving? So the octave key here goes up from A and above, and it's actually this little secondary octave key for below. So that's a great question. Let's go to some more questions. Okay. You know, I need to adjust there we go, just so I can see better. Okay, so Tanner is here. Hello to Tanner. And Amethyst is here. Hello. Mike, yes, you are correct. We are early today, as I explained, because of the holiday. And let's go to this question. GJ, okay. Hello from NYC. Oh, you know, I'm having a little bit of trouble with, I got to fix this here so I can, my cool little comment system here. There we go. Bloop. Let me go a little bit this way. So anyway, GJ says, I love your channel so much. You're the best educator ever. So thanks a lot, GJ. Let me know, are you a student learning how to play? Are you an adult learning how to play? Are you a teacher? But thank you very much for that nice comment. And Mike Hamilton wishes everybody a happy Independence Day. Thank you, Mike. Amethyst says it is 10 a.m. where you are. Oh, and it's Mike's 14th wedding anniversary. Round of applause for Mike. Happy anniversary to you. Very nice. Ice Legend is in Miami, Florida. How's the weather down there in Miami? It is, right now it's kind of, it's been a little bit weirdly stormy, but also it's kind of sunny today. Nice blue sky, some clouds. And I guess it's about 70. Let me ask. I'm going to ask Alexa what the temperature or what the weather is, okay? Ready for this? Echo, what's the temperature?
Right now, it's 76 degrees Fahrenheit. Tonight, expect a low of 64 degrees.
Very exciting. All right, so it's very nice out. Amethyst is in Phoenix, Arizona. Ice Legend said the sound is good. Thank you. Mike is asking, can I play I Was Born to Love You, Freddie Mercury? Let me look that one up. I was born to love you. Also, guys, today, because of the holiday, we're going to not do with a full hour. We'll go about 45 minutes, okay? Let's look up this song by Queen. And while that's loading, let's see here. Tanner says, Tanner's from Denver, Colorado. Awesome. I'd like to hear where you all are from. Yes. I sell my house, my fridge is... I am selling my fridge. You are technically correct because my fridge is going with the house. So, yes. True to my name, sell fridge. This is actually the first time I'm selling a fridge in my life. That's amazing. Okay. LPS Julia TV says, I'm starting summer band soon. So that's exciting. I'm starting... So LPS, I'm going to call you Julia because Julia is in your name. Julia, if you could let us know just a little bit about your summer music program. Are you going every day? Is it like in the afternoons or in the mornings? We have our band camp for high school marching band is starting in August. And then in July, we have Wednesday night practices. We just do sort of not mandatory Wednesday night practices. And then in August, we go really serious with our full-time band camp, and that's required. Okay, so Uncle Joe liked that joke. I could predict that. So let's say hello to Michael Cias. Greetings from Cape Town, South Africa. Hello. You're welcome. It's my pleasure. And oh, that's a good song. Maybe we'll do. Okay, we'll do Chuck Mangione. We have Mike's request of I Was Born to Love You. Is that the song you requested? I Googled it, right? Yes. Let's do that right now. Guys, keep your comments and questions coming. I'm going to go back to Mike's request right now. And let's give a little listen to this song, okay? Again, I put this music on. I always get my copyright. They don't give me a strike. They give you like a little notice. See, this is Freddie Mercury with Queen. I was born to love you with every single beat of my heart. Here's the here's what I'm watching. Okay. I find out what key it's in first. Oh, it's an F, A flat major. Put my neck strap on while we're listening. So when I teach these songs, everybody, what I try to do, because song, you know, a typical popular song will have like an introduction. It has a verse. It has a chorus. The chorus is usually the catchiest part of the song, called and it usually has a hook. Actually, the recent videos I've just posted on Blinding Lights. That's the wrong key. Anyway, that's the hook of the song, right? So I have to try to find the hook of this song because it takes a long time to teach like the whole thing. Find the... All right, I'm just going to do that much, all right? I was born to love you. All right, so Mike, I'll teach you the first phrase, okay? Just for time, just for timing reasons. This song is in F major for alto sax. So F, F, G, A, B flat, C, D, E, F. It's an F major scale. Starts on a low F. Then it jumps an octave key. And then what happens next? Ba, ba. Da, da, F, E. So F, F, E. E, F. C, D. No, D, F. That's an interesting interval. So, F, F, E, E, F, D, F. Okay? Is that right? Let's listen to it one more time, and then we'll move on. Love. Yeah. So F, F, E, E, F, D, F, F. All right, that's a nice song. Let's move on, just because I want to get to as many requests as I can. So Michael had asked about I Feel So Good, Chuck Mangione. We'll get to that in a few minutes. Let's answer some questions, okay? Amethyst is asking about My Shot from Hamilton. Yeah, and that's it's a nice... you know, today being the 4th of July, Hamilton, you know, the founding fathers of the United States. We played that song in band one year. Let me come back to that. Ice Legend says, I'm learning alto sax, learning on my own. Let's get some more comments here. Dev says, freestyle, play on sax. Like somebody just freestyle. I could do that. That's easy. Just pick a, you know, if you want to just freestyle, like experiment. You know what? I have some improv videos coming out soon with a friend of mine, Dennis de Blasio. And one of the things he talks about in the first video is how to just freestyle on a pentatonic scale. So let's just take a pentatonic scale. I'm going to take G major pentatonic, which is G A B D G A B D E G. Now, if you want to freestyle or improvise, take a major pentatonic scale, which is any major scale, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, and then 1 on top, or 8. I'm going to do some freestyle for Dev on that G major pentatonic. Here we go. Now, if you want to get a little bluesy, you take that major pentatonic and you put, in addition to the regular third, you put a flatted third. So I'm going to add a B, but also a B flat. So that sounds really, you know, I don't know, maybe it sounds kind of like, wow, that sounds really hard or impressive. It's just a pentatonic scale. So if you get good at your pentatonic, you can freestyle it. All right. Ice Legend says, the weather is always crazy in Florida. It's sunny, and then it's Hurricane Irma. Tanner Man from British Columbia, Canada. Denise is requesting a video on Happy by John Lennon. I actually don't know that song. I can look that one up. I have a couple of requests in the queue now. I've got Hamilton, My Shot, and I've got da 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 da. Boy, the old brain is not working. Chuck Mangione, Feels So Good. We'll get to that. Let's get all of your questions in. Amethyst said it rained pretty hard last night. Oh, and it rarely rains in Arizona. It rained quite a bit here yesterday in the Philadelphia area as well. Hello to Dorcas Dufy Kona. It's good to see you again. I've seen you on here before. Hello to Nancy Art. And Dorcas is from Ghana. Oh, I'll answer this one real quick, okay? The correct placement of the trumpet mouthpiece, okay? So it's good to practice with just your mouthpiece. Take your thumb and two fingers. And for most people, the correct placement of the trumpet mouthpiece is just direct center in the center of your lips and evenly spaced on your top lip and your bottom lip. So center, center, center. So just like that. Now, there are some professional players who develop their own sort of idiosyncratic ways of doing trumpet. And if it works for them, then that's great. You know, trumpet can be a very, there can be some very individual aspects of how people play the trumpet. But in general, starting off a beginner, I would teach them center up and down, center left to right. Okay, there's your answer. Break a leg. I'm 50 years old and I just started playing the trumpet today. All right, let's all have a round of applause for Break a Leg, who just started trumpet today. A beginner book for trumpet. I have a great book for you. Now, it depends. If you want a book that has a lot of explanations in it, I would recommend books. There's a book called Tradition of Excellence. I spelled it a little bit wrong, but you get the idea. I would call it Trumpet Book One. Any of these, Book One. Yamaha is a good one. They have fingering charts and all that kind of stuff. What's another good one that people like? Any beginner band book would be great and has good explanations in it. Hello to Mia Ann. Amethyst, can My Shot be played on flute? Okay. I'll play it on flute when I get to it. And Tanner just said Essential Elements. Thank you, Tanner. Because Essential Elements is another good beginner trumpet, a beginner for any instrument. Putting that in the chat. Okay? All right. Let's get to all right, let's get to the request of Chuck Mangione. This goes back to earlier in the show from Michael. And I'm going to Google this. Feels so good, Chuck Mangione. Here we go. You know, a live version might be cool to watch. Let's watch a live version here.
Mangione is the master of fusion music. He combines great melodies and hot rhythms to form an exciting musical experience. His latest album, Feels So Good, has just gone platinum. So here's Chuck Mangione.
I think that's the right key.
Who will make you feel so good.
Ba-da-da. How do I get my, make sure I get my side camera on here. I know I'm showing you my behind the scenes. Oh well, I can't figure this out right now. So here's the introduction. Yeah. Oh no. So this one, again, this is a longer song that would take a long time to teach. I'll teach you the beginning of it, okay? We're going to be in a D major scale. So it's D major, D, E, F sharp, G, A, B, C sharp, D. It starts on an F sharp, so it's on the third. And it goes, Mi, Fa, Sol. F sharp, G, A, E, D, C sharp, D. I bet if you look this up, you could find a PDF. I would go Feel So Good, Alto Sax PDF. I'm just going to search that real quick. Here it is. Look, I found it. So it's right there. Okay, so Google that and you can find it yourself. So hopefully that was a good start for you. Let's get to some more questions. And we will get to my shot. Let's do America the Beautiful for Mia Ann. Okay, here's a good one for Patriotic July 4th. Do I have this on my website? Let's see. Live stream. I'm looking on my website. Do I have America the Beautiful? The Star Spangled Banner. Oh no, that's a concert band arrangement. I thought I had Patriotic Song. Guess I don't. Okay. Never mind. Here we go. It's a very nice song, and I bet you could find that if you just searched America the Beautiful sheet music. I'm sure you could find it. Shrek is a legend. All right. Yes, dad jokes. My brother, for whatever reason, my brother texted me yesterday and wanted me to send him some dad jokes. So I had a couple in my repertoire. Let's see. I have a good dad joke. What was one of them? Uncle Joe, I wonder if you know the answer to this one. If anyone knows the answer, the dad joke answer to this question, put it in the chat. What is the best thing about living in Switzerland? Do you know what is the best thing about living in Switzerland? Put the dad joke answer in the chat. All right. So in the meantime, let's go to Mia. No, Amethyst's question of my shot on flute. My shot, flute PDF. Let's just see if I get lucky here. The thing about my shot is it's got a lot of rapping in it, but I'm pretty sure it's got like some melodies in it. Let's see. I think that's it. So I'm just trying to find a version here. Okay. I'm looking through. All right. Maybe I need to just look it up here. My shot, Hamilton. Let's look it up.
All right. I am not throwing away my shot. I am not throwing away my shot. Yo, I'm just like my country. I'm young, scrappy, and hungry, and I'm not throwing away my shot.
So this part.
I'm gonna get a scholarship to King's College.
So all of this. All of this so far is he's rapping. There's no real pitch. There's no real notes to it. Sort of a pitch he's singing, but it's all kind of one. Okay, so. So I'm going to teach you just like the melody of the bassline part, because when he's rapping, there's real no melody to it. It's that's what when you rap, you're rhythmically speaking. So I can tell you this part at the bottom. It goes. Da da. So it's G. Let me just make sure I'm doing it right. B flat, D C. Okay. G A B flat. D, C, G, C, F sharp. Okay? It's kind of awkwardly low for me to sing. I'll play it along.
Only 19, but got a lot of brains, but no polish. I got a holler just to be heard with every word. I drop knowledge. I'm a diamond in the rough.
Yeah, it's all like, it's G minor, which is kind of fun. All right. Let's keep moving here. Shrek had the Junkyard Jive on trumpet. Let me put a pin in that one. I'll come back to it. Denise Smith is learning to play the sax at 68 years old. So that's awesome. Ice Legend. Did anyone get my answer to the dad joke? No. Nobody got it yet. What is the best thing about living in Switzerland? The answer is, I don't know, but the flag is a big plus. Okay. Let's do this. Any tips for tonguing on saxophone? I find it difficult to separate notes. Half, quarter, eighth notes. The only advice I can think of right now is remember when you're tonguing on any instrument, any wind instrument, there's two kinds. There's legato and staccato. There's what we call connected style and separated style. Most of the time, you should start learning connected style, and that means your air never stops. Imagine like your airstream as a long, here in Philly, we call it a hoagie, a long sandwich, a long submarine sandwich, a long roll, right? And then simply when you cut that airstream into different notes, your tongue is just slicing the air like you just slice through real quick with a knife. Just go whoosh, whoosh. So it's do that on a B. So here's our hoagie or a submarine sandwich uncut. Now the tongue is just going to go little slices on that hoagie. Okay, then you try double time, cut it into smaller pieces, eighth notes. But the air is, and then you split it up into smaller pieces, 16th notes. So there is the first thing I'd like you to work on for tonguing, okay? Michael Wolf is saying hello from Mexico City. How's the weather there in Mexico City? I hope it's nice. Happy 4th of July. Thank you from Tom for a happy 4th of July. Samantha Beyond, my sister's playing percussion. Wants to know if I can play Star Wars theme song on percussion. Sure. I actually have. All right. I'm going to have to go get my. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to show you this. Okay. Give me a second. Okay, you guys? Give me a sec. I'm going to get this for you. And we're going to go to my alternate camera angle. I have my bell kit. Here it comes. Look at this. See that? I'm going to put it here. I just so happen to be set up with my alternate camera. So look at this. Let's go. I need my bell mallets. Do I have a set of matching bell mallets in my... There we go. Look at this. See? It's a good thing I have a junk drawer where I keep everything. Here are my bell mallets, okay? And we're going to go to my alternate camera angle here. We're going to do Star Wars for Samantha's sister, okay? Now, I don't know if you say your sister plays percussion. I don't know if your sister does more snare drum or bells. But in my school, we start on... we do a bell kit and a snare drum. Because if you're a percussionist, you need to know both reading melodic notes on the bell kit or the xylophone. And you also need to know how to do rhythms on like snare drum and things like that. So this is Star Wars. Let's go over here. Let's see if this works. Okay. Let's go here. Let's move this a little bit so you can see. All right. That works okay. If we go this way, there we go. Okay. So, here we go. For Star Wars, we're going to do the main theme of Star Wars. Bum, 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 bum. We're going to go B flat to F, right? B flat, F, and then we're going to go down, E flat, D, C, right? You got that? B flat, F, E flat, D, C, ba, high B flat, F. All right, let's practice that again. B flat, F, E flat, D, C, B flat, F, repeat, E flat, D, C, B flat, F, E flat, D, E flat, C. It's a lot to it. All right. So I don't expect you to learn it like the first time I show you, but maybe you can go back to this live stream and you can watch it. It goes up on YouTube. You can watch the replay. So here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's a slower version. Sorry. I missed that time. All right, and they go. It's a fast version. Ah! I'm kind of awkwardly set up here. I'm not quite getting the right angle on my notes, but that's okay. Let's go back here. So my piano cam worked, was useful today. That was fun. All right, let's get some more questions, and I still need to get to Shrek's request. And Dorcas is asking a video chat with me only. So Dorcas, working out a way to do, because I, you know, in COVID, I've been doing a lot of Zooming and video chats with my students and teaching classes. So if some of you are interested in something like that, that's something we could probably work out. So just stay tuned, and I'll put out some information about that, possibly setting up, if you want to do a one-on-one lesson, we could do something like that, okay? All right, thank you, Samantha. And what's the name of the song played by Japan Lady Marching Band, The Red Cats? Let me look it up. Did you put a link in the chat? Yeah, so I'm not finding it with a quick Google search, but if you can send it to me. Okay, Michael, thanks, Dr. Suffrage. I'm also the team captain of Butler Youth Development. Hey, all right, cool. So that's great. That's awesome that you're doing that. I guess you play saxophone because you asked me to play it on saxophone. Thank you, Michael. Mia Ann, God Bless America on flute. Chloe, were you watching when I just did Star Wars on the bells? I actually don't have a lot of percussion videos, and I really need to do more. But if you want to learn some easy songs on bells, I'm going to put that on my to-do list to do more beginner bells videos. thank you, Uncle Joe. All right, so let's go back to, I want to do God Bless America for Mia, but let's go back to Shrek's question for Junkyard Jive, okay? Again, I just go to YouTube or I Google it. Junkyard Jive Cuphead. Let's see what we get. Ooh. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. I'm just going to teach you the beginning. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Ba-da. Ooh. Ba-da. That's an A minor. Sorry. So that's C A G F E. And then it changes.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
D, C, B, A, G sharp. So C, A, C, A, G, F, E. And it goes back. Back to it. That's basically it. And pretty much that. Okay, so that was fun. Let's do questions, and then we'll do Mia's question of God Bless America on the flute. Isaiah, ask another dad joke. Okay. Does anyone know the answer to this dad joke? Why are elevator jokes so great? Why are elevator jokes so great? All right, we'll come back to that one. Bye, Amethyst. Amethyst might already be gone. Tanner, yes, saxophone is an awesome instrument. Thank you, Chloe's Fun World. Here's another playing request. I might not be able to get to that today because we're almost out of time. I want to get more comments because I still have to do a God Bless America. I think that's the only thing I've promised to do so far. Hello to, what's going on here? There we go. Hello to Kweku, Prince, and Michael Wolf, starting to learn clarinet again, and ukulele at 57. That's great. Tom Easton, my favorite instrument and why? I would have to say saxophone because that's the one that I really fell in love with and got really, fell in love with music playing the saxophone. I started on clarinet and I liked playing clarinet. Oh, by the way, guys, I found, maybe I'll play this for you next time. I'll reveal it to you. I found an audio tape of me practicing clarinet in like 1990. And I was like 12 years old, right? Yeah. So, I was surprisingly, I sounded better on the tape than I thought I did at that age. I was playing Christmas songs. Maybe I'll show that to you, okay? Thank you, Shrek. Samantha's sister. Oh, okay. Samantha's sister is Chloe. All right. Awesome. Thank you all for being here. Did I get interrupted in the middle of a thought there? Oh, yeah. My favorite instrument and why is, I'd have to say saxophone because I switched to saxophone after clarinet and then I got really good at saxophone because that's my favorite. Nancy Art. All right. So this is a common issue with holding a flute. I have a video, Nancy, if you can search my channel, it's called how to not drop the flute or something like that. How to not drop the flute. And I talk about the four points that you have to hold the flute. You've got your right thumb, which is one of the main supports down here. Actually, yeah, your right thumb is your only finger. Your right thumb is your only finger that does not play any keys on the flute. Your right thumb, its only job is to support the flute. So you kind of balance it here. You got your right hand pinky, which holds down this E flat key most of the time, unless you're playing a D note. Okay, and then you've got your left thumb, which controls this key, but really is not really a source of support. The source of support on your left hand is this part of your index finger, which presses against the flute. And then the final part of support is the flute pressing against your lip. So you've got this hand kind of pressing the flute into your lip, not hard, but enough to hold it there. So if you practice balancing it, I can hold a note literally. Right now I've just got my right hand, my thumb, and my pinky, and I hold here, and I can play the no finger note. That's a D flat. And I've got no problems. I know a lot of beginners, they keep dropping their flute. Work on those four points of balance, okay? Schedule for live band is every Sunday. Usually it's 2 hours later than I started today. 3 p.m. Eastern, but today I started earlier and I have to go soon because it's 4th of July. Michael, thank you for that. Ah. Oh, it's going to rain this evening. Okay. Good. That's a good answer. My answer to why the answer to the dad joke, why are elevator jokes so great? It's because they work on so many levels. Okay. Do you have any tips for jazz improvisation? Yeah, Ian, I don't know if you were here when I was talking about, and I didn't forget about, I'm going to do God Bless America next on flute. I didn't forget about that request. Improvisation. All right, here's my number one tip for jazz improvisation. The way jazz improvisation began in the history of music is people taking a melody and just starting to play around with the melody by adding rhythms and adding their own maybe little melodic slight changes to it. So you take a melody like, let's go super simple. Let's go Mary Had a Little Lamb, if you guys know that song. Or Merrily We Roll Along. It's like the same melody. Melody in your head. Da, 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 da. So just imagine you're going to keep playing that melody over and over again, but each time do something different with it, melodically, rhythmically. Don't be afraid to play sounds that you try something and it sounds, ooh, that didn't sound very good. That's okay. You just know, all right, I won't do that same way because I didn't like how that sounded, or I'll change it up. So here we go. I'm going to jazz up Mary Had Little Lamb. Right off the bat here, I'll go right into to jazzing it up. I'll start off very simple, and then I'll get more complex. One, two, three. A little bit more complex now. Little tricks about how to add in bluesy notes and how to make it, how to just, you know, add your own personality to it. Okay, let's go to, see you, Uncle Joe. Thank you, Mike. You're welcome, Chloe. Yay. Make sure you guys, you know, check out my channel. Check out everything I have on there. You can also go to my website where I have lots of stuff up there. It's Dr. Sell... Let me get this right. Music.com. Did I spell it right? Yes. Okay. All right. Let's go to God Bless America. Nice way to maybe close things out. This was a request from... Who was this request from? Mia? Was it Mia? Mia Ann? I want to find it. There it is. Oh, no. America the Beautiful. I will find this, everybody. God bless America. Yeah, here we go. Here we go. I gotta figure out what key I'm gonna do this in. Okay. Okay. So I'm gonna do this song in E flat major. This song starts on do. Do, ti, la, ti, la, sol, re, do, re, mi. This is how I figure out songs in my head using solfege. Here we go. God Bless America in E flat. Thank you. That's the big high note that everyone wants to sing. All right. So that's a great way to finish off the show today. GJ is liking my t-shirt here. Yeah, this is actually this is going to be my July 4th shirt. This is the 76ers, Philadelphia 76ers basketball team, red, white, and blue. Yes, Dorcas, if you could, actually, guys, when we close this out, you guys are going to see a way to email me. So let's see, is this going to work? Yes. So you'll see get rid of the chat here. So drselfridgemusic@gmail.com. You guys can contact me there. If you have questions about doing, you know, individual lessons or video chat, might be able to work that out. So let's go back here and get ready to finish up. I want to thank you all for being here. Let's get my jazz going here. Thank you all for being here. We are ending, as I said, about 45 minutes. It's time for me to go hang out with my family for a nice day of 4th of July, you know, barbecuing and all that stuff. So I hope there wasn't anything I promised to do that I didn't get to today. I think I got most of the requests. Did anyone get my... Oh, yeah, they work on so many levels. The elevator joke. Okay, bye, Christy. I'll see you next time. You're welcome, Nancy. Thank you, Tom. I appreciate it. Break a leg. Thank you, Samantha, Beyond. I will be back next week. I should be, yeah. Assuming I'm not like buying a house or something, but like I said, it's been a little bit crazy with the home buying stuff. So every week, every Sunday, if you want a quick shout out before I go, get it in there in the chat. But other than that, folks, have a great week. All folks who are celebrating in the U.S., have a great 4th of July, Independence Day. And everybody have a great week. Make sure you practice. And if you're not a subscriber, subscribe to the channel and do the notifications and all that stuff. So thank you so much for joining us at our unusual time today. Mike, thanks. I'll see you later. And everybody, Wilchins Plays. I want to get you a shout out because I haven't heard from you yet today. So shout out to you. Thank you, Mike. Folks, I will see you next time. Have a great week. Bye-bye.